Godot is always growing, and sometimes useful features can go unnoticed for a long time. Here are 25 unusual tips and features you might not know about. You can split the screen to multiple viewports in the editor by using the View menu. You can display the selected camera view by turning on the camera icon. But more useful than that, you can enable Cinematic Preview. This will display the currently active camera's view, which is a great help to craft cutscene animations, showing your camera cuts while we play the animation. You can use built-in scripts to quickly test things without creating a script file. The built-in script will be saved inside the scene, and no script file is created. Godot lets you record gameplay videos. In the project settings, go to Editor, Movie Writer, and set the location where the video will be saved. After that, enable the Movie Record button and play the game. The gameplay video will be saved when the game is closed. If you make games inside dark environments, it might be a bit hard to see things in the editor. To fix that, you can open the perspective menu, disable the environment, and enable the default light. And now you can see and place things more clearly. If you are tired to adjust properties of resources inside resources, you can right-click the node and open its sub-resources directly. Now we have the full inspector dedicated to that resource. You can change the wheel style of the color picker. To set the default color picker, go to Editor, Inspector, Default Color Picker Wheel, and choose your preferred color picker style. You can right-click scene nodes and check its dependencies. With this window, you can quickly replace all the linked nodes of one type for another. You can also view owners of a scene or resource, listing all other scenes that are currently using them. Locking parent nodes will not disable selection on child nodes, but you can achieve that by setting the parent to group selected. Now child nodes won't be selected anymore. If you hold Ctrl while releasing a scene into a node, it will be added as a child node. And you can press Shift instead to add it as a sibling. You can use meta variables to add information to nodes without having to add a custom class for them. With this, you can add a type metadata and check for that on the collision callback. You can use the Add Tool keyword to turn your nodes into editor tools. The script icon will turn blue, but you still need to save and reload the scene for it to work. Now the nodes process function will be executed inside the editor. You can add warnings to your two nodes by using the getConfigurationWarning function. Returning a string inside a list here will give you a warning error. You can use this to give reminders of how to use your custom nodes. You can use getSetDefinitions, custom functions that are called when you are trying to set or get the value of a variable. But note that editor exported vars only calls getSet functions if they are editor tools. Otherwise, this will only work when the game is running. You can use the super keyboard to make sure the extended classes call their parent functions. You can connect signals with the one-shot flag. This will automatically disconnect the signal after it is fired once. You can use lambda function declarations to keep your callbacks code near your signal connections to make sure it's clear what it does. You can create simple timers with the await keyword. And while this works, you can cancel it or check for its state. This can lead to situations where it is called several times in a row. To fix that, you can also quickly create timers with tweens by using the tween callback and the set delay functions. This way, you can save the tween instance and check if it is running and even cancel the current tween before it is executed. You can use Bandler-style hotkeys to move, scale, and rotate objects. With this, you can lock movement to an axis and type the precise amount to move, or use your mouse to adjust it. To enable this, go to Editor Settings, Shortcuts, and add the shortcut for Begin Transformation Tools. You can change the editor FOV inside the View, Setup menu, as well as the min and max drawing distances. You can format strings using the percent sign. Using %.1f will display only the first floating point of a float. You can use the debug profilers to analyze your game's performance. The profiler can tell you the time each function is taking. The monitor can see your game's memory usage, draw calls, and nodes. And the visual profiler can check for the rendering details. If you don't see the results here, go to Editor Settings, and under Debugger, reduce the profile frame history size. Start again, and now things should work. You can set the game to be always on top. This allows you to change objects' properties while running the game without losing focus, which is a great way to debug things. And that's it! 25 more advanced tips and tricks for the Godot engine. I hope you liked this video, and until next time!